Hello! Welcome to the tutorial video series about its magic engine. In this series, I am planning to provide its magic engine tutorial from scratch. The continuation of this series will depend on me getting good feedback from the videos. So the number of likes and views is important. Now let's move on to today's training part. You can download its magic engine from Play Store. When you log in, you will see the age verification and privacy policy. Enter your age or any age, and then accept the privacy policy. If you have done these steps, it will bring you to the start screen. Next, we need to create a project. We must create a new project from the new project section. Its magic store has a lot of ready-made content, free or paid, in this video. I want to use through the old Counter-Strike map. After selecting the project, you must enter the project name. Otherwise, you will encounter an error. You will enter the project name in the section that says project name. Then we create the project by pressing the create button. When the project first opens, it will compile the scripts. So you need to wait a bit. Let's take a look at the panels. The objects panel on the left is where you can see the objects in the world and make adjustments. The files panel at the bottom is where you can check the game files. The 3D editor panel in the middle is where you can make edits to the world. The game panel next to it shows the view in the game. And you can play the game here to start and stop the game. You can start the game with the buttons such as stop, start, pause at the top and middle. The coding panel is where you edit the scripts in the project. The properties panel, located just to the right, is where you can play with the details of the object you have selected. The terminal section is where you can see the errors in the game and make corrections accordingly. You can transfer the products in the market to the current game. With the store panel in the middle, you can check the values of the game in the profiler panel. So, RAM usage, current FPS value like. Next, let's take a look at some of the settings you can access from the four square icons. At the top left of the editor, there are various settings in this section. We can save the project from the Save Project setting here. It is useful to save it from time to time. Your progress should not be lost in possible crashes. In the World Settings section, you can make settings that will directly affect the appearance of the game. You can make some settings of the project in the Project Settings section. For example, the interface resolution can be adjusted here. The Editor Settings section is where you can play with the settings of the editor you use. If the performance of the device is low, better performance can be achieved with settings such as rendering distance or resolution. From the cube and plus sign icon on the top left, you can get use in the project with a simple cube or objects such as terrain and road supported by the engine. That's it for today. As I said at the beginning, the continuation of this series will depend on the number of views and likes of this video and its sequels. I am normally develop on my phone, but for this video series, I shot videos with the help of an emulator. See you in the next videos.